Hi, so in this video I will show you how to use mlpack with an example. So we will try to implement linear regression using mlpack today. So let me explain to you in brief what is linear regression. So we have one input variable and one output variable, and we have some points here, and our goal is to pass a line through these points such that the distance of each point from the line is as minimum as possible. So something like this. Now we have one input variable here, so that's why it's called univariate LR. Okay. Then what if we have two input variables and one output variable? So again, like, we will have some points here, and this time instead of a line, maybe we'll be fitting a plane here. So we want to fit a plane through these points, and since there are two input variables involved, thus it's called bivariate linear regression. And similarly, there is a multivariate linear regression wherein we have multiple input variables, multiple dimensions. So for example, if there are n input variables, then we'll have n plus one dimensions. And this plus one is because, like, there is also an output variable. So I will use this data set for linear regression today. This is a data set which is available in this UC Irvine machine learning repository. This is for combined cycle power plant, and you can see here, like, the data is multivariate and we can use it for regression task. So we'll be doing multivariate linear regression today, and there's some information about data set here. Like, it has around 9568 points, and I think there are four input variables and one output variable. So if you scroll down here, you will be able to see all the variables. So temperature, ambient pressure, relative humidity, exhaust vacuum, these four are the input variables, and net hourly electrical energy output is the output variable. And you can also see there are some ranges given here as well for these different variables. So what I'll do is we'll have to download this data set. So I've already downloaded it. So I've extracted the data zip folder and I've copied it here. So let's check out what is there in this data folder. There's a folder called ccpp. You can ignore this readme file. This is something which I had created. And here, there are these files present. So for now, you can ignore these two files. I'll explain to you what I've done in a moment. But you should be able to see these three files here. So you get ODS file, you get an XLS file, and there's a readme file. So let me show you how this XLS file looks like. So this is how it looks like. So there are, like, five columns. These first four are the input variables, and the last one is the output variable. So this 80 is temperature. This is I think exhaust vacuum, this is ambient pressure, and this is humidity, and this is the energy output in megawatts. And you can see there are five sheets here, so there's a lot of data actually. And what you will need to do is you'll have to export this data to CSV so that it's easy to load it. If you go and try to export it by going to file and then save as CSV, then it will only allow you saving one sheet at a time. So what I have done is I saved it in three separate sheets, and then I combined it into one file for this train and test.csv. So the train.csv is combining the three sheets, and test.csv is combining the rest two sheets. So that's how I've made these files. So I've already written the code for this task. So let me go through them. So there are two files, LR train and LR predict. So this is for training and this is for some prediction based on user input. So let me first open LR train. Okay, so it's not big file, it's a very small file, and it's relatively quite simple. So first I am reading the path to the data file using the command line arguments. Then I am creating an empty matrix for predictors, wherein I'll be loading this data from CSV file. And also I'm creating this empty field. I think this is a column vector of string, so that I can store the values of the headers. And then I'm using predictors.load, and inside that I'm passing this CSV name. So this is a function which accepts the file name, the headers, so that it can fill the values of headers after reading. And also I have to pass this option here for transposing the data, because in Armadillo, the matrices are stored in column major format. So like they do processing column by column. And that's why like we have to transpose the data during load. So once it has been loaded, now as you have seen in the CSV sheet, the last column is the output variable, okay? And we don't want that last column because we only want input variables. Like we want these two separated. We want input variables and then we want output variable separately. So what we do is, since the matrix has been transposed, we need to fetch the last row from this predictors matrix, and we have to store it in responses as an output variable, and then we have to remove that row from the predictors matrix. So we are separating out the input variables and the outputs. And then what we do is we use this linear regression class. We create an instance and we pass these predictors and the responses which we had created earlier in the constructor. And when we use this constructor, it will automatically run the training during construction itself. So later, if we want, we can print the computed error, which is I think the mean squared error. And then we just save the model into this model.xml file using this data save method. And if you're wondering about this model, I will show you later what this model means later. And then we pass this LR object, which we had created earlier. And that's it. That's how this training works. So next, let's look at LR predict. That's also, so that's also a very small file. So again, like we are reading the model file as in the command line arguments. We are creating an empty linear regression object here. And then what we are doing is we are using data load to load the model into this object. And then what I'm doing is I'm taking these input variables from standard input, so that user will be able to provide some input, and then we'll be able to show them like what is the predicted output. So we take these values and we put them in this column vector. And then we put this column vector in a matrix called points. And we also create an empty row vector for storing the output, the predictions. And then we use lr.predict function, and we pass the input points, the input matrix, and also the output where we want to store the predictions. Now in this program, I have only one set of input, that is one column vector, but you can also have multiple column vectors in this matrix. So like you will be able to see multiple values like based on the input. So if we run a for loop here, then we will be able to see the prediction for each input set. So that's lrpredict.cpp. Now let's try to compile and run these two programs. So we will use this command for compiling. So g++ the lrtrain.cpp, then we will store the output in this executable lrtrain. We will be using O2 optimization level. Then we want to include the include folder which was present in the installer directory, and then we link with Armadillo, otherwise it will throw some linker errors. So let's try to run this. Okay, I think we have a typo here, sorry. Yeah. So it has created this executable lrtrain. So let's run it. Okay, so it needs the data. So data and train.cpp. Okay, let's see. Okay, so it already loaded the model and it completed the training. So you can see like these were the headers which was detected, and this is the error that we are getting from this model. And it has generated this file model.xml. So let's try to see. Yeah, so here is model.xml, and if we open it, so this file contains it is an XML file, and it contains all these things here. So you can see it is generated by serial. It has n rows and one column. That is, I think, because it stores in column major format. So actually it will be one row and five columns. So these are all the values of the parameters, and there are some additional information like lambda and whether the intercept has been considered or not. So now let me show you one more thing. So if I go to lrtrain and let's say if I change this to something like LR model, okay, and if I try to compile this again, and if I run this again. So, and if I open the model.xml file, so you can see here it has changed from model to LR model. So this is very important. You always want this to be same when you are creating a model and when you are loading a model. So make sure that this is always the same. So what I'll do now is I will revert it back, and then we will have a look at lrpredict.cpp. So to compile lrpredict, we will use this command. I think it is the same, only the file name, the input file name and the output file name has changed. So just let's just run it. Okay, so it has compiled successfully and it has generated the exe. Let's try running it, and we will need a model file path, so I'll just give model.xml. okay, so it has loaded the model and it is now asking for the input. So let's give temperature, for example 30, ambient pressure in millibars, so I think we can give like 1001. I'll give 90% humidity and exhaust vacuum in centimeter mercury, so I will give maybe 100. Okay, so we are getting some output here. So we are getting 419.812. So it seems it is correct, because if I open the XLS file here, we can see the output is in range of 400, 460, 450, 430, and so on. So I think the output is correct, but let's try to run it once more with some different different inputs. So let's keep the temperature as 50, maybe. So ambient pressure, it will be low, so maybe 700 millibars. I think I'll keep humidity to 10% and the exhaust vacuum to 80. Okay, so the output has been decreased, so maybe these conditions are not quite ideal for good energy output. So now I also want to show you how to use command line tools for training and testing linear regression. So let me go to mlpack 4.2.0 build installed there bin, and we have the mlpack linear regression here. So I will use this command for training. So mlpack linear regression, then we'll specify the training file. Then minus V for showing some additional details. And we want to specify the model file where we want to store the model. So let's run this. Okay, so it has already done the training, and it has loaded the model in this file, lr.xml file. And if I do ls again, yeah, we can see lr.xml here at the top. So now you must be wondering, like, since we had used the same training data, whether the same model has been generated. So we can do def of lr.xml with the one which we had generated using C++. Hopefully we should not see any differences. Yeah, no differences. So the same output, same training done using CLI tool as well as in C++. So you can also use these tools. Now, if you want to also run testing using the CLI tool, then I think you will need to do some more pre-processing. So let me show you. Yeah. So what you'll have to do is you will have to cut off the first four columns from this test.csv file, and you'll have to create a new file from that, because otherwise it will throw some errors that the dimensions don't match. So it only expects like four values in input. So let's do that. Okay. And the file has been created. So now we can run this file, this command for testing the model. So input model file is lr.xml, which we had created. The test file is the test input.csv file. And this is the file where we'll be storing the output predictions value. So let's run this. Okay. So I think it has run successfully. Let's open output.csv and see if there are some values there. Yeah, there are some values there. Although it doesn't look quite well in format, but it seems it is correct, because this is like 439.95 and so on. So we can try to use awk command for seeing this in better output. So if I, yeah. So we can do it like this. So awk printf %g and then a new line character. And this should probably work out. Yeah. So now you can see that the output is in correct format now. Thank you for watching this video. Hope you found this video informational.